Hey everyone, Simon here. In this video, we are going to talk about the Henry George Theorem, which I believe is vastly underappreciated. The theorem first of all proves that a practical implementation of Henry George's single tax system is actually possible. And it also provides a framework for how local governments should invest. Before going further though, I quickly want to give a huge thanks to everyone who have recently joined the channel. It really is a huge motivation for Nikolaj and I to see that people are interested in our content, and it helps us spread the message about land value taxes and Georgism. So once again, thanks everyone for joining, and with that being said, let's jump right into the video. Local governments face two major problems. The first problem is that local governments cannot make money and are dependent on taxing people's income. Whenever they spend money on improvements for the community, they end up with a net loss, causing them to be financially stagnant. This stagnation means that no matter how well a government is performing, it will not gain more buying power. This puts a strong limitation on how well governments can perform. So what can we do to make sure that governments don't become financially stagnant? The Henry George Theorem provides a clear answer to this problem by stating that local governments should be run as a for-profit business. See, under the single tax system, the only source of revenue for governments is land value taxes. And that is great because land value is the one thing that local governments can influence. So whenever the government makes an improvement that increases the land value in its municipality, it will generate a profit from its investment. Now we've created proper economic incentives for the government to be as efficient as possible. Since governments can now make a profit from their work, they will have better funding available to solve problems. For example, finding a way to house homeless people might suddenly be easily achieved if it is profitable in the long run. Or for example, making sure that the local schools are performing well will be a top priority in order to raise land values further. As the municipality continues to provide good services, it will in return become richer. And this means that they can invest more money, make a better profit, and grow their services over time. Now we have a system where the municipality improves itself over time and without being dependent on taxing people's income. Another benefit of the profitability is that local governments will be able to attract more talented people, since the competitive nature of a business will attract the highest talent. The second problem is that they have no frame of reference to know whether or not building or improving a local service makes sense. They simply have to make judgments based on their own perceptions. This is not an accurate way to invest, and therefore we often see governments providing too much or too little of a service. We also see investments that completely misses the mark and provides no value to the community. For example, the ghost cities in China, where housing was developed by the government, but the cities have no residents. So how do we solve this problem? Is there a simple and objective way for us to judge whether or not any project is worth the money? Yes, there is, and here the Henry George Theorem again provides a clear solution. The municipality should only invest in projects where the value of the land will increase more than the price of the project. And why is that? Well, under the single tax system, the government makes money anytime it makes an investment that increases the value of the land. The larger the increase in land value is, the more money they will receive in land value taxes. So if the price of the investment is smaller than the value that the land increases with, then the government will end up in a surplus. The reverse situation will result in a deficit. So if the government only make investments that satisfy this rule, then this will enable them to cut away all projects that provide no real value to the people, which also leaves more resources for essential projects. The problem of government employees making judgments based on intuition is replaced with a clear mathematical judgment. The theorem also explains how much of a service should be available. It might be difficult to judge how many trains per hour should be running in a metro if you have to account for affordability, comfort, and speed. But with the theorem, the answer is simply that if adding an extra train increases the value of the land more than the cost of adding an extra train, then we should add another train to the metro. So to sum it all up, the importance of the Henry George theorem cannot be understated. If used correctly, this theorem will enable governments to be self-sustainable, and it will simultaneously make sure that governments only make improvements that are actually valuable to the people living in the community. Thanks for watching. If you want to learn more about land value taxes and Georgism, then I encourage you to go check out the subreddit page on Georgism. And if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a like. Feel free to subscribe to the channel, as this really helps the channel grow. Also, if you have any questions, please post them in the comment section down below.